Subscribe now. The Pixel 2 is Google's second attempt at creating an Android version of the iPhone 8 and a proper competitor to the Samsung Galaxy S8. Instead of focusing solely on top-end specs and including every feature imaginable, it aims to offer users the cleanest Android experience possible. For the most part, this means you're getting the best of Google in a phone. However, there remain a few areas where improvement is still needed. The smaller of the two Pixel devices is rumored to have been made by HTC, to a Google design, of course, but there's very little of the Taiwanese firm's DNA in this phone. Actually, the Google Pixel 2 feels very different to any other Android phone I've used this year. Even though it's constructed from aluminium, the back has a stony-like finish. It's harsh and textured, strange at first but, ultimately, super nice. It's far grippier in the hand than shiny aluminium and isn't as slippery when sat on a table the same way a glass back is. Neither does it appear to pick up fingerprints. It does give the impression that it might scratch off over time, but we'll have to wait and see if that becomes an issue. The smaller of the two Pixel devices is rumored to have been made by HTC, to a Google design, of course, but there's very little of the Taiwanese firm's DNA in this phone. Actually, the Google Pixel 2 feels very different to any other Android phone I've used this year. Even though it's constructed from aluminium, the back has a stony-like finish. It's harsh and textured, strange at first but, ultimately, super nice. It's far grippier in the hand than shiny aluminium and isn't as slippery when sat on a table the same way a glass back is. Neither does it appear to pick up fingerprints. It does give the impression that it might scratch off over time, but we'll have to wait and see if that becomes an issue. AMOLED panels are renowned for offering more saturated colors, perfect blacks and better contrast over their LCD counterparts. But I'm sure that the main reason Google opts for these panels is because OLED is necessary for Daydream VR to work, which, of course, is a big push for Google. The single biggest reason to choose the Pixel 2 over any other handset is the camera. On paper, the 12-megapixel f/1.8 unit sounds fairly pedestrian. In use, however, it captures some wonderfully detailed images that are often much better than those produced by the competition. Video capture is excellent. The camera now uses both eyes, electronic image stabilization, and OIS, optical image stabilization, to help avoid jankiness, resulting in a smoother image. Footage is recorded up to 4K 30fps, but you'll probably want to stick to 1080p at 60fps if you're shooting anything with a lot of motion.